Today we will explain the cooling tower thermal efficiency, that how can we calculate the cooling tower thermal efficiency if we know the wet bulb temperature, range and approach. Range and approach were explained in the previous video, however in this video we again use these terms to calculate the cooling tower thermal efficiency. Tower thermal efficiency, we need these terms: wet bulb temperature of the atmosphere, range and approach. What is cooling tower? The cooling tower basically is a heat rejection device in which we bring air and water together, and after coming into contact of these two air and water things, then water give its heat to the air, and due to evaporation phenomena the water becomes cold and its temperature reduces. As this phenomena occurs, reducing the temperature of the water being circulated again through the tower, and then we use this water to remove the heat from the our processes. So range, this term we explained in the previous video, but again we explain this definition. The range is basically the difference between the cooling tower inlet temperature, which is hot water, and cooling tower outlet temperature, that is the water coming outside from the cooling tower and it become cold. So this difference of temperature is called range of cooling tower. So range of cooling tower is equal to cooling tower inlet temperature minus cooling tower outlet temperature, or you can say that hot water temperature, which is at the inlet of the cooling tower, and cold water temperature, which is at the outlets of the cooling tower. With the help of this difference, we call a term known as range, and we calculate the difference of the temperature and defined as range. The other term used in this calculation is approach. The difference between the cooling tower outlet temperature, that is the cold water temperature, and the ambient wet bulb temperature is called as approach of the cooling tower. So the approach represents basically the cooling tower capability, that how much a cooling tower can reduce the temperature of the hot water coming from the system. So approach of the cooling tower is equal to cooling tower outlet water temperature minus wet bulb temperature of the atmosphere. So approach is equal to cold water temperature minus wet bulb temperature. Now we will explain the term wet bulb temperature, very important term. There are two terms used: wet bulb temperature and dry bulb temperature. Now wet bulb temperature is the lowest temperature to which air can be cooled by the evaporation of water into the air at a constant temperature. Now the wet bulb temperature is measured by placing a thin film of water on the bulb of thermometer, or you can say by dipping like this. This is the wet, or you can say water, thin water layer around the bulb of the thermometer. So now when this water layer is present around this wet bulb, then this temperature is called wet bulb temperature. However, a non-wetted thermometer reading provides dry bulb temperature, which is called DBT. This thermometer, which is not surrounded by any of the water layer, now the temperature reading on this thermometer is known as dry bulb. So if both of these thermometers are placed in the same environment, however one is surrounded by a thin layer of water and other is without any thin layer of water, then the temperature measurement will be different, because the wet bulb temperature is always lower than the dry bulb temperature, or you can say dry bulb temperature is always higher than the wet bulb temperature, only except in one condition, which we will explain you now. Now the wet bulb temperature is always lower, this is I explained you, from the dry bulb temperature. Why? Because when the air is fully saturated with water, that is a condition known as 100% relative humidity. When these both thermometers are placed in a 100% relative humidity, when a high humidity, around 100% humidity, then these two thermometers read same value. and dry bulb temperature is equal to wet bulb temperature. So question arises, when both temperatures are same, that is dry bulb and wet bulb. The answer is when both thermometers are placed in 100% relative humidity, the temperature will be same. At this condition, both wet and dry bulb temperature are same. Now we come towards the explanation of cooling tower efficiency. Now a tower cannot cool the hot processing water to a temperature lower than the wet bulb temperature of the entering room. This is thumb rule, that a cooling tower, it is impossible for a cooling tower to cool a hot processed water lower than the wet bulb temperature of the entering air, because the lowest temperature attained by the air coming outside of the tower, it can have a lowest possible temperature equal to wet bulb temperature, and normally its temperature is higher than the wet bulb temperature. So it is impracticable to design a cooling tower that can provide cooling tower equal to or lower than the prevailing wet bulb temperature. So whenever you are going to design a cooling tower, you must know the weather conditions and the temperature data around the all the weathers and the year, that what is the maximum wet bulb temperature and what is the minimum wet bulb temperature in that area. On the basis of that, because it is not possible to attain the water temperature which is coming outside of the cooling tower after cooling, that it become equal to the wet bulb temperature of the atmosphere, or you can say below than that. So that's why this is the thumb rule. A tower cannot cool the hot process water to a temperature lower than the wet bulb temperature of the entering air. And it is not possible to design a cooling tower which can provide so much cooling which is equal to or lower than the prevailing wet bulb temperature, because now it is not possible to reject the heat where in the atmosphere, because now the both temperatures are equal. So when both temperatures are equal, heat will not move on the other way side. This diagram, again I repeat and explain the hot range approach and this phenomena. So this is hot water temperature coming inside into the cooling tower and coming from the process industry or some process which is now carrying the heat and want to dissipate in the cooling tower. This is the cold water temperature which is going out after cooling. So this difference is called range. Now this is approach. Now that is the cold water temperature which is going out from the cooling tower, and the wet bulb temperature, that is the air coming inside to the cooling tower. Now this difference, that is temperature of wet bulb temperature which is maybe equal to the air temperature, or normally it is lower than, but we say that difference between this cold water temperature and wet bulb temperature is equal to approach. In basically the air is coming inside and out mean water is going out, and here water is coming inside. So cooling tower efficiency is the ratio of the actual cooling, that is range, to the theoretically possible maximum cooling, that is when the approach is zero. That is, there is no difference between the cold water and the ambient wet bulb temperature. So this formula is used to calculate the thermal efficiency of the cooling tower. Cooling tower inlet water temperature minus cold water outlet temperature divided by cooling tower inlet water temperature minus wet bulb temperature into 100. So eta is equal to T in minus T out divided by T in minus T wet bulb into 100. We can further simplify and correlate this efficiency with range and approach by using this expression. Range is equal to T in minus T out, and approach is T out minus T wet bulb. So by rearranging these expressions, we put these in this equation and we get efficiency is equal to range divided by range plus approach into 100. This gives the efficiency of the cooling tower. Very simple. That is, we only need the temperature, inlet temperature of the cooling tower, outlet temperature of the cooling tower and wet bulb temperature of the atmosphere of the where air is coming inside the cooling tower. Or if you know the range, you know the approach, you can use this expression, which is also derived by using this in and out temperature and wet bulb temperatures. Very simple calculation, and making the concept that it is not possible for a cooling tower to reduce the temperature of the water below wet bulb temperature of the surrounding atmosphere. So in practice, the cooling tower efficiency will be in between 70 to 75%. In summer season, you know that the ambient air wet bulb temperature raises when compared to the winter season. So cooling tower efficiency limiting in summer season. Normally in summer season, because the temperature are higher and especially wet bulb temperature is also on the higher side as compared to winter season, so the cooling tower efficiency is limiting in the summer season. That is, we have a limitation that we cannot get maximum efficiency in the summer season as compared to winter season. So this brief video is about the cooling tower efficiency, and we also again explain the range, approach and wet bulb temperature. So keep watching our videos, and we will try to provide you more useful information related with the process industry, water treatment and other useful topics. Please do not forget to subscribe our channel.